My condolences to anyone who's ever lost me, and to anyone who got lost in me, or to anyone who ever felt they took a loss with me. My apologies for the misunderstanding or the lack thereof. I'm sorry you missed the God in me, and I'm sorry you missed the light.
If you're back for another video, that means you are a loyal member of the Bab Squad, which means that you have already subscribed and hit the notification bell. You like, you comment, and you interact with me on social media because we're friends and you're amazing. So I just wanted to bring you guys a Halloween look. I was hell bent and determined to bring you guys some Halloween looks this year. Like, I let the season pass me last year and I was like, no, next year I'm gonna be on it. So this is my very first, like, super creative look that I've ever done. I've never used fake blood before. I've never done, like, this vein work under my eyes. This vein work, I don't know, like, I don't want to get too close. Like, maybe if I back up, you guys can see it better. But this was inspired by someone I saw on Instagram when I was just searching around for Halloween inspiration. I will definitely pop her picture up right here so you guys can see. I used the Urban Decay Born to Run palette and the Juvia's Place Zulu palette to complete the eyes. Yeah, like, this glitter on my face is the Urban Decay Heavy Metal Glitter in the shade ACDC. I'm using it all the time. So if you've seen any of my videos that incorporates glitter, it's more than likely that glitter. Yeah, so, like, that's all I have for the intro. Like, I love, love, love Halloween. I'm an October baby. I'm born on the 13th, so Halloween has always been one of my favorite holidays. It's just so, I don't know, it's just so fun. So, like, my makeup skills aren't exactly on the creative, like, studio effects skills side, but I did my best, so I hope you guys enjoyed this glampire vampire look. I added a little blood, you know, as an extra little something, I don't know. But anyway, just comment below and let me know if you liked it. If you enjoyed this video, give it a big thumbs up, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.
Okay guys, so first things first, I'm gonna do the face, because I feel like doing my face lately before I do my eyeshadow has just really been working out. Also, I have my wig slicked back into a ponytail, so I'm not bald, guys. If this is your first video, hey, this is a wig. I'm natural, I'm not bald, and I know I got my little slick back going on today, so I just felt a little insecure for 0.5 seconds, so I wanted to just bring that to life.
Okay, so moving on to the look, the first thing I'm gonna take is actually a new product. It is the ColourPop Brow Boss Pencil. So I've never used it before. I got this at work in a gratis bag. This shade they gave me is Soft Black, which is actually perfect because I tested this look out one day when I went to Walmart, and I really, really liked it, but the only thing I wanted to tweak was, like, my brows. Like, I wasn't sure if I wanted to use the NYX Brow Pomade, which is what I've been using. Like, that's what I've been using. So, I wasn't sure if I wanted to keep using that or not, but I remembered I had this pencil, so I can just use this instead. Okay, so far this pencil is fire, and honestly, I almost want to stop using it and use the NYX Brow Pomade instead so I don't run out, but so it's not exactly dark and dramatic enough for me, so I'm going to go in still with my NYX Eyebrow Gel in the shade Espresso. My lips are so dry. Okay guys, this lip gloss has nothing to do with the look. My lips are just so dry. Okay, so if it was like super bright earlier, I really apologize for that. I turned the brightness down, so hopefully this is a better vibe. Maybe I should start the video over. I'm trying to get myself out of this whole perfectionist thing that I have going on before it becomes an actual problem. So I apologize for the brightness, but I turned it down, so let's keep it moving. So now I'm going to take my LA Girl Pro Concealer in the shade Toffee, clean up under the brows, and on top of the brows, I'm going to clean up with LA Girl Pro Concealer in the shade Beautiful Bronze. Before I go in with the concealer, I'm going to add a little bit of my NYX primer to my eyelids.
skin prep for this look is as follows, okay? The L'Oreal Lumi Glotion in the shade Dark Deep. Makeup Revolution Priming Oil, or Baking Oil. And then I'm gonna do the Photo Loving Primer around the perimeter, and then the Pore Filter, both by NYX, and this one is gonna be in the T-zone. So the foundation for this look is the Maybelline Superstay Foundation in the color Truffle. To highlight, I'm going to be using this shade in my Anastasia cream contour kit. I would take it out, but honestly, that's just nasty, and I have on like a beautiful black dress, so I'm really not trying to fuck all that up. So I'll be using a concealer brush and just putting that on. So I'm gonna switch it up and add in my contour before I blend out my highlight. I never do this, but I'm taking the darkest shade in the Anastasia kit that I just showed you guys to add in my contour. Let's get into the eyes. So I want the eyes to be really bold, so I'm gonna start with a strong black base. So I'm gonna use the Maybelline New York Eye Studio. I think this is an eyeliner in Black is Black. To start blending out the black, I'm going in with my Morphe M506 brush and the Urban Decay Born to Run palette. I'm going to be using the shade Hellride.
It's done now, it's done now. Oh, time's up. You never know the day will come up. Hey, should've been there. I told you, play the game.
Before I add another brighter pink to finish out the eyeshadow, I need to go in and add a little bit of Jet from the Born to Run palette on top of the black so that it can lock it in, because my black keeps trying to run away. Intensify the look just a little teensy bit more because I'm extra and I'm never satisfied. I'm going to go in with my Morphe 505 brush and the Juvia's Place Zulu palette. I'm using the bright pink shade, but only a dash, and I'm really not sure about it, so let's see. Oh, yeah. The underbrow highlight, I'm taking the Makeup Revolution blush palette. It looks like this, and I'm going to use this shade over here. Next up in our vampy glam is to take all the products that we used up top and drag them down for an incredibly dramatic look. One of my favorite parts about this look was adding the glitter. If y'all have been following my channel for any length of time, y'all know that I love this glitter. I'm obsessed with it. It's the Urban Decay Heavy Metal Glitter in the shade ACDC, and I use it in so many different ways. But today, I'm gonna be using it on my underline, and I'm gonna be using it as vein detailing on my face. So get into it, sis. For the lips, I am going to use the MAC lip liner in Night Moth and Kat Von D's lipstick in the shade Wicked, I think. Yeah, I can't even see it anymore. It's in the shade Witch. Now for the best part of this entire experience, the fake blood. So I think I'm gonna add the fake blood. Okay, first of all, if you're using the one that says vampire blood, it's runny as fuck. So just to let you know, you will ruin shit if you're not prepared because it stains like shit. So my blood, I want it to run like down my mouth and like maybe down my neck too. I don't really know. Like I want it to kind of look like I was feasting on something and like the blood drips just kind of got everywhere. But we'll see. Well guys, this is it for the glampire look. If you guys recreate it, make sure you tag me on Instagram and on YouTube and whatever else. I would really love to see you guys' recreations. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye.